Okay, hey everyone, Rob here, and today we're going to be doing a Let's Play of Red Dead Revolver for the PS2. It's originally released back in May 3rd, 2004, so we're dealing with another 10-year-old game here. Let's see how well it holds up. It's one of my favorite games from the PS2 era, and I consider it a classic, especially when it comes to Western games, which we don't seem to get too many good ones nowadays. This game seemed to gain a pretty big cult following over the years. Without this, we wouldn't have Red Dead Redemption, so we kind of owe it that. So, originally developed by Capcom in 2002, but they dropped it. So Rockstar bought the game and reworked it, making it a spaghetti western, adding more violence and over-the-top characters and stuff, so it's definitely got that Rockstar aesthetic to it. So let's go ahead and get started here. Okay, we're going to be doing story mode today. I've kind of loaded it up, got my character ready and stuff, did a little bit of testing with the controls. So, do a new game. Okay, Bullseye, Chapter 1. Young Nate Harlow built a cabin and, wow, that's kind of blurry. Built a cabin a ways away from Bear Mountain, partly to get some distance from the Red Wolf tribe after some folks weren't happy about him marrying Falling Star. Okay, so here's a young version of our hero, Red. Not really all that impressive.
Troubles are finally over. We hit a vein of gold as wide as a locomotive that runs clean through Bear Mountain.
Hey, Pa, where'd you get that?
Isn't she a beaut?
Yeah. Can I hold it?
She's one of a pair, only two in the whole world.
Where's the other one?
My partner Griff has it. We made him up special to symbolize our newfound wealth.
Can I try it out?
One day this fine weapon will be yours. But for now, why don't you take my old pistol?
Oh no, you can use my own piece of shit one.
Well, I give your ma her gifts.
His gun's kind of cool though. You don't really get a good look at it there, but it's got like a scorpion design on it. So you follow the fence path down to the creek bed to learn how to shoot. Your left analog stick to move. Tilt rotate camera with the right stick. Alright, let's head down to the creek bed here. Not that I really need the training, but for the sake of the let's play, we'll go ahead and do this real quick. Training section. It's fairly basic. Aim with L1, line up your target when it turns red, fire. Shoot the shiny. Seriously, come on. See, that's been kind of the thing that kind of irks me. Well, not irks me a little bit. I mean, it's a 10-year-old game, but you're never quite too sure about your shots. Either you line up just right and you hit them, you know, you hit them in the arm or something when you're doing trying to do a headshot, or sometimes you're just way off. You're not even aiming at them, and you still hit the bad guy dead on. So, oh, missed one. You'll see what I mean when I'm playing.
Red Harlow, what are you doing to my pots and pans?
Now don't henpeck the boy. Next trip into town, I'll buy you a whole bunch.
Well, she's not too bad. Looks like Nate did pretty good for himself. Oh, shit. Bad guys.
Red, up the hill and quick, boy. We're getting raided.
I'm coming, Pa.
That's one of the cool things about this game that I really liked when it came out is it's got a lot of references and homages and stuff to like old spaghetti western films. So if you're kind of a western fan like I am, that's pretty cool. A lot of, if not all, the music in the game has been recycled from old spaghetti western films. Movies like His Name is King and They Call Me Trinity and stuff like that. You'll notice the themes pop up in the game. Especially, I think the one that was playing at the very beginning of the game, that's the theme to His Name is King. And that was also played in Django Unchained, if you guys have seen that. So you'll kind of, if you've seen that film, you'll start to notice a lot of these themes. Tarantino reused a lot of that music and stuff for that film.
Put the gun down, kid! I'll get you, boy!
Ah! Bastard.
See you in hell.
One of the things that they implement into the game here is you rack up cash. Of course, that's how you pay for everything. But you get cash for each shot that you do. If you hit him in the head, I believe it's like $8 for headshots. $6 if you can get him in the arm. $2 in the chest. And I think it's like $4 you hit if you hit him in the leg. So it starts to rack up over time. And then you get multipliers. If you kill one guy, rack up those points, kill the next guy immediately, it multiplies. And you keep going from there, and you can chain your kills and boost it up even higher.
Him being such a yellow belly and all.
Nice shot. Okay, that numbnuts that just got shot there, that was Colonel Darren. He's, just so you guys will know the name, he'll pop up several times throughout the game. And he's basically not the main villain, but one of the guys that Red's gonna be hunting down later on. Because you know how these things are, it's always gotta be about revenge. Cash. Good. Should be better than that. Can you? And see, now we got to look here at a much older Red. Who's obviously been practicing with his guns. He's kind of grown older, became a badass and stuff somewhere along the way. And you can see they modeled his character after Clint Eastwood's Man With No Name. And he's even got that cool leather glove sash thing around his arm. A lot like the Man With No Name had.
Easy there, friend. Come on over here. Come on now. It's too dangerous for a man to be walking around in these parts.
What the hell are you doing here?
I deal in weapons and goods, see?
Okay, so here's our introduction to our first merchant. It looks like since my old save file was on here, I bought most of this stuff already. It's not really important to the Let's Play here because it's just showdown characters and journal pages, which... We'll just go ahead and buy the knife here. We're not going to be doing any really showdown stuff in the Let's Play, so...
I would have offered you more than that. But the gang of ruffians done run me off of my... I didn't...
You're holding out on us, old man!
What the hell are you looking at?
Not much, apparently.
Full of lead.
For all your shit-talking, you guys weren't all that tough. Okay, well, we can either do the little training section here, but I'm just going to go ahead and skip it. Because basically it just tells you pull your gun and hit square to take cover. Go ahead and change to my rifle. Boom. I usually prefer to play with the rifle. You get a lot better accuracy. You get more rounds before you have to reload. And does a lot more damage. Ow. See, if you play your cards right, you can usually take out these numbnuts with one or two shots. Like so. I'll take that, thank you very much. And that. Alright, I will do the little training for this, because I'm kind of rusty. So let's learn how to use a Deadeye. Hit, draw my gun. Doesn't matter which kind. R2 to set it up. And then just run it over the guy's body here, and then hit R1 when you're ready. Fairly simple. It's a pretty neat trick to have in the middle of a fight.
I'm going to make mincemeat out of you. Get ready to meet your buddy, Hunter.
Damn it. I'm starting to aim like I'm drunk now. One of the things that sucks though about the Deadeye is that usually around bosses and stuff, doesn't seem to do much. It's only good for like henchmen.
That hurt.
And still. Hold on, wait. Not ready. Okay, wait. Alright, now I'm ready. Damn it. Alright, reload. Not that these guys are actually making me break a sweat. That won't come until later on when the difficulty starts ramping up. Cut it out.
Son, you done killed them all.
Yep.
You know, you can get quite a handsome bounty for these fellas if you took them down to Sheriff O'Grady's in Widow's Patch.
I'll be taking your cart.
Whatever you say, bounty hunter.
Could at least offer him something for it. Let's see, so we got Bloody Tom. Got about 507 bucks. Excellent. Alright. Got a couple of showdown characters. Let's go ahead and push on through. Okay, now we get the chance to purchase some more weapons, some more journal pages and crap, so get the revolver. As you can see, it's not a huge improvement, but it's very fast, very short. It's better than the other two options. I guess we're going with the Halcon and the knife.
Much for the lot.
Well, you did good, son, but you're out of luck. Take a look around. There ain't much here. I got nothing to offer you. Bugler gang is done destroyed my town.
Look at that mangy mutt. That damn doggone leaved himself all over them fancy boots here.
Oh shit. Yeah, they're gonna pay for that. Alright, let's go, assholes. Nobody kills an innocent dog in my town. Even though I just strolled into town.
Please.
Stand still.
You son of a...
There you go. You just lay down there. I'll take care of the rest. Where are you? There you are.
Who did that?
Still, let me kill you. There you go. All right, who's next? It's kind of the thing about the game, though, is you will see a lot of the same character models and stuff pop up repeatedly throughout the game. Nice. Still. Yeah, you guys ain't nothing. Alright, Hedgehog. Let's go ahead and get my Deadeye lined up here. If I'm lucky, I might kill a few. Ow. There you are. Oh. Oh. All right, we got another duel. All right, let's do this. All right, let's go ahead and do the tutorial. Excuse me. Okay, so we got four phases. We're going to grab the gun. Push forward to pull it out. Okay, then we start acquiring the locks. Okay. Poor shot. Yellow. Dark red. Bright red is a critical. Easy enough. R1 to acquire each lock. You have a maximum of 6 locks. I'll fire once the phase has ran out. If I want to end it early, I hit R2. Easy as pie. Alright. Let's do it. Critical, get a dick shot. Belly shot, chest, head, boom. Not bad. Want to practice again? Nah, we don't need to do that. So knee, dick, gut, chest, head, boom. Now see, the hard part is trying to do that fast. I can do it right now because it's slow. But later on in the game, it becomes a big pain in the ass, especially the boss at the end. So, is that it? Am I done?
I'm looking at a dead man!
Alright, Blondie, let's go. Ow. I might want to reload. Where are you? Shit. Yeah, you go ahead and hide for a while, bitch. I'll come get you. Where'd you go?
You son of a...
There you go. Is that it? Okay, who's left?
Yoo-hoo, here I am!
I'm gonna poke your ugly head out. I can't find you. There you are. There you go. I'll take that.
Where are you running off to, Sheriff? You may have beaten my gang, but you ain't gonna get by me!
His innocence is shield, huh? Halcon out. Line up my shots. Gotta be careful not to hit the sheriff. If you hit him just right, he'll drop the sheriff. Give me a chance to get a few shots in. Aw.
I'm gonna make you pay!
Give me a second. There. Gotcha.
Excuse me, mister. Mister, please.
Oh, nice.
You gotta help my ball. There's no doctor left in this town.
Well, I'll do it for you.
The closest doctor is in Brimstone. Sheriff Bartlett might offer you a handsome reward if and you can get me there.
I'll send a telegram and tell him about your arrival.
$865. Aw, I was hoping for an excellent. Let's go ahead and continue. And then we got an option of some more showdown character, journal page, and then the breach loader, which I'm going to go ahead and buy this. And I'm going to go ahead and put this episode to an end, guys. So we'll go ahead and jump into level 2 here in the next little bit. Be sure to share, comment, and subscribe. This is Rob signing off, and I'll see you on the next one.